name's Colin. I'm an Oregon Health and Science University fourth-year dental student, and I want to talk to you about one of my favorite foods, oats. If you love them, that's awesome. If you avoid them at all costs, stick with me and I'll give you the lowdown why they're one of the world's best foods.
Did I mention how easy it is to make? All you have to do is add 2 to 3 parts simmering water to 1 part oatmeal, salt to taste, and then cook to taste. Let's give it a shot. Turn her down to simmer. We're gonna let that bad boy go. There's a couple different ways that oats are prepared, and they all follow that formula.
Our list of most of the kind of oats that we have, we've got our whole oat groats, whole, probably not gonna cook them. Steel cut, Irish, they're cut 2 or 3 times. Stone ground or Scottish, they're gonna be the most creamy. Rolled oats, those are steamed and then rolled out so that they're able to cook a little bit better. And then instant oats, those are your run-of-the-mill camping type of stuff. Usually come with a lot of sugar in them. The differences between all of these are mostly just cook time, longest to shortest. Texture, chewiest to the mushiest. And the glycemic index, lower is better. Just because they've been processed less, steel cut is the lowest glycemic index.
My favorite oats are the steel cut because of the texture. Bob's Red Mill actually won the annual Golden Spurtle World Porridge Making Championship in Scotland with this exact recipe. While this is cooking, I'll drop some history on you. Oats were first thought to be used in Egypt in like 2000 BC. Not only for food, but for relieving redness and itchiness of the skin. That's right, those oatmeal baths you've heard of were first used by the same folks that made the pyramids. Oats ended up being super useful to lots of civilizations because of its ability to grow in harsh conditions, and it made its way to North America in the 17th century. Back in 1945, it was the first time that oats were marketed as colloidal oats. Those were used in the oatmeal baths that everyone keeps raving about. Finally, in the 80s, oats were shown to contain a compound called avenanthramides. And since then, oats with this avenanthramide compound have been shown to not only reduce itchiness of the skin, but also to be anti-inflammatory, anti-atherosclerotic, and antioxidant. Let's check on that oatmeal.